Davao City Mayor Sara Duterte Carpio accuses Malacañang and opposition coalition group Isambayan of playing what she called a slapping contest over a proposed Duterte-Duterte tandem in the 2022 elections. Duterte Carpio says she doesn't understand all the fuss since her father already declared she is unfit to be a president because she is a woman. Her statement comes as the ruling PDP Laban Party calls on President Duterte to run as vice president in the 2022 national elections, while welcoming Duterte Carpio as the possible presidential bet. Opposition groups see a Duterte-Duterte tandem as unconstitutional and a move toward political dynasty.
Meanwhile, former Philippine Defense Chief Gilbert Teodoro says he's willing to be Davao City Mayor Sara Duterte Carpio's running mate should she decide to run for president next year. Teodoro says Duterte Carpio did not say for sure if she would seek the presidency in the 2022 polls during their meeting last week in Davao City. That meeting fueled speculations about a possible tandem between them in next year's elections. Teodoro says while nothing is certain for now, he believes Duterte Carpio is fit to become president.
My impression of Mayor Sara talking about issues was that she would make a very good president of this country. She would have the ability to unite a lot of people. She has an independent mind. She has managerial skills, you know, running a very complex city like Davao. I'm willing to back her up. I'll gladly be her vice president.
Teodoro also thinks Duterte Carpio's possible presidential bid does not amount to political dynasty.
There were two President Aquinos. There are two President Macapagal's. So, I mean, it's people that vote in any case. And I think you cannot consider Mayor Sara to be within the spirit of what a political dynasty is, because I think she's quite independent-minded and has, you know, a mind of her own, and she knows what she wants to do management-wise. That's my opinion.
Malacañang spokesperson slams the opposition claim that voters will reject the potential 2022 election tandem of President Duterte and his daughter, Sara. The president's spokesperson, Harry Roque, belittled the Isambayan opposition coalition and insists it does not speak for a majority of Filipinos. Roque also brushed aside objections to President Duterte possibly becoming his daughter's vice presidential running mate.
See you on election day. Taong bayan po ang magde-decision dyan. At saka, nakapagtataka naman, no? Bakit kaya ang akalain ng eleksyon, sila ang tagapagsalita ng taong bayan? Kung titignan mo mga surveys, wala pa pong 5% ang hindi sumusuporta sa ating presidente. Baka boses lang kayo ng isang barangay.